fuck over, boy. Yeah, 700, between 5 and 700,000 copies. Like, why is there a gap there, first of all?
I heard it was like six and a half.
Yeah, I heard about 6.5, but I don't know why they on here talking about it's a gap.
I don't know. You know, sometimes it takes, you know what, fluctuate last minute and shit.
But you know what I really noticed? This is a straight marketing standpoint, and I'm not even picking sides or nothing on this point. Everybody and their mother pushed Drake's shit. Pushed it. I'm talking about Cobalt Music. I'm talking about Apple Music. I'm talking about Spotify. I'm talking... I went on my phone and opened Spotify, and the first thing that popped up, hey, Drake just dropped. You want to listen to it? I didn't get that with Kanye West. Nobody was pushing Kanye West shit like that. Drake's shit was literally every fucking where. You couldn't miss it. You couldn't miss it. And they dropped, both of them dropped on the same platform. Both of them are Apple exclusives and shit. Both of them, you did not get that, like Kanye West did not get that same promotion at all. I don't know why. I don't know what's behind the scenes.
But Kanye also had like a huge rollout. And Drake did not.
But Kanye West paid for that. Kanye West did all that. Kanye West set all that up.
But at the end of the day, I understand he set it up, but like at the end of the day, looking at the way the streams reflected and everything, like either way, regardless who paid it, it's like, nigga, you did this whole event for your rollout and then like did half the sales that Drake did. You know what I'm saying?
My biggest thing is I was not expecting Kanye, like literally I was not expecting Kanye to outsell Drake. That wasn't gonna happen. Period.
Right. Right.
So I'm just looking at percentage wise at this point. Like Drake's number one. Drake's number one in the fucking world. You can't deny that. Like as far as art, as far as being an artist, as far as how many fans he has. Like the Beatles. Beatles was like number one in the world, but there were better bands than the Beatles. I think maybe. maybe.
I don't know.
Right.
I don't know. I'm not.
I just bought a Beatles.
Hey, I don't want no smoke from the Beatles hive and nothing. So, you know what I'm saying?
Hell no.
I don't respect it. But yeah, I know what you mean. Records. I mean, I think you know Kendrick is making the best music out of anybody right now. You know what I'm saying?
You see what I'm saying? Like, Kendrick will never touch Drake's numbers.
You said what?
Kendrick will never touch Drake's numbers. Is it the best that...
When Kendrick drops, he'll do the same numbers as Drake.
650?
He'll do 6-something.
I think his highs was like 605 or some shit.
I think he'll do that much.
Number one on the chart with Billboard's rapper, number one on the chart with 324 copies sold. Then it was down. The most he's ever sold was 603,000 albums. It was the Pimp a Butterfly. The one he won a Pulitzer Prize with.
Right.
But I know, I think as far as album sales go, Drake, Kendrick, Kanye West. Kanye West is not going to sell as many albums as everybody else. That's period. He does not have, especially when he goes straight gospel. Especially when, you know what I mean? Like he doesn't.
I'd probably put Kanye even below Cole.
Cole?
How many streams of Cole? How many albums of Cole do his last album?
The largest.
Even Travis Scott, like I don't think he's even top five right now for real.
First week sales 218,000 was his highest.
What for Cole?
Yeah.
218.
Let me see.
That don't sound right.
Which one album sold the most? Beat the number one. Or so jars. Let's see. Let me try to share it. Yeah. Bing, bing. J. Cole, Forest Hill Drive. Beat that number one. How many? Is that gonna tell us how many. All right. So album sales, but doesn't tell us any numbers. But thanks, right. Billboard. It's fucking Billboard. Let's
see. I'm trying to hide that shit.
All right. This is what it said before. 218, J. Cole released debut. Oh, that was debut. Cold World. Cold World should have got more than that.
Yeah.
But J. Cole highest first resale, so like sum it up. J. Cole's first resale. J. Cole's off-season. Off-season, come on. Jermaine's latest project was 280. Like, he don't be selling units like that. He doesn't have that type of fan base either. Like, J. Cole has a large fan base. 282. Hmm? Yeah, 280, like,
it's 282.
Yeah. That's like a Kanye West. That's what I'm saying. Like, they got their cult following. Like, they'll always be good with that 300, 4, you know what I mean? Anywhere from like 250 to 350 type numbers.
Right.
Drake is fucking global. He is pushed by, you know what I mean? By the mob. Straight up. That's why I'm like, I'm never going to sit there and say anybody's going to sell more. That's like Lil Wayne when he was busting out a million a week. You know what I mean? Like, get the fuck out of here. Ain't nobody was touching that shit. When was the last time somebody did that?
No bullshit.
Nigga, a million.
Like, that was before streaming, though.
That makes it worse. That makes it even worse. Like, what? A million CDs? Nigga?
Not really, though.
Why?
Because you know how streaming fucked the game up.
Oh, saturated.
1,500 streams, one album sale, bullshit. Fuck out of here. Pow.
That makes sense. I mean, it doesn't make sense.
1,500 streams equate to one album sale? That makes sense to you?
Only because it's the accessibility thing. I don't know where the number 1,500 came from, but I understand why a certain amount of streams. Like,
can they show me the math? Can they show their work on that? How did y'all come to 1,500?
1,500 is probably, I think, if I had to guess, it's because the lowest amount to sell an album for, it has to be $3.49. I think 1,500 streams equal $3.49. That's my logic. I don't know.
That just went over. I don't know.
Right. Like, just,
I don't know. The math still don't check out for me. But yeah.
I mean, because you got to sit there and just, you got to, first of all, none of it makes fucking sense. I'm going off of what they're saying. Because for anything that makes sense, you got to tell me what a stream is worth. 3 cents.
Whatever they say is worth.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. So it's
whatever
like,
they say is worth.
Whatever they
say. But we know some bullshit, though. That's what I'm saying is we know.
So
300 streams is not worth the same as it. We know that.
So if I'm playing
for someone
game,
to listen to, if someone listened, got your album, listened to it 1,500, listened to all the songs 1,500 times.
No.
But I'm saying, though, think about that. If you had a CD that got played and each song, it totaled up to 1,500 streams.
Oh,
who the fuck is listening to an album that much? That's crazy. That is nuts. That's one purchase? No. That's like multiple people listening to equal 1,500. You see what I'm saying? 1,500 plays of a song. That's really what they're talking about. Stream is a play of a song. So we're talking about 1,500 times a song from that album was played. You're telling me that came from one person? One sale of one album? That sounds like 10 people to me. To get 1,500? If I have an album, I'm like, it's 15 songs on there. Maybe I listen to each song, like, 10, to, like, 20. Like, huh? You know what I'm saying? Like,
but over
I love that album. If I love that album.
But over the lifetime of you listening to an album, how many times have you played Kendrick Lamar album?
Who the fuck knows?
Exactly. Over a lifetime. Not the first week, but over a lifetime. They're like, all right, look. For this could be considered a sale, we got to know that people like to listen to it. and over 1,500 plays. I've definitely played a Kanye West album. I've definitely played College Dropout way more than 1,500 times. Way more than 1,500 times. Way more. That's guaranteed. So I got my album's worth out of it. I'm not saying they're saying the math makes sense. I'm just trying to make sense of their math.
Those are classic albums. Like, that's not really fair. That's not really fair. I was like, you really chose like the holy grail all right, of fabulous albums. Like, yeah, I've listened to College. I've listened to Thriller more than 15. Like, who the fuck had, like,
fabulous.
You know what I'm saying? Like, in general, like, it's just not, the math don't check out for me. The math on 1,500, you got to bring that number down. That number, it doesn't check out. Well, now, way too much of a listen to only equate to one album stream.
No, now you're talking about taxes. That's how it sounds like to me. It's like, all right, the one percenter's got to, you know what I mean? Like, once you hit a tax bracket or a stream bracket, it got to be less streams for us to count as album. Because if they're way up there,
maybe.
You see what I mean? Maybe. If they're way up there, nah, you got to get 1,500. 1,500 for that shit.
Maybe, because maybe it's weighted. Maybe it's a weighted system. Exactly. Maybe it could be a weighted system. Exactly. I'm not mad, you know, but like, make it check out though. Don't give me 1,500 across the board.
Right. No.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
I get that.
Like, especially an artist like me getting 1,500 streams, you're going to tell me that's one, like, nigga, are you serious? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, 50, I get streamed 1,500 times, you give me one album, are you kidding me? Like, that means, like, way more, you know what I mean? That should be weighted way more to a nigga like me. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, they should make that math kind of check out a little bit. Like, they should, you know?
Like, the percentage of taxes you get out your check. You see what I mean?
Exactly.
It's like, nigga, you making millions and I'm getting taxed the same as you. You know what I mean? Like,
exactly. Like,
what the fuck?
Exactly.
You wilding, exactly. Yo.
Exactly. Exactly.
That's what I mean by taxes.
They need to improve the system. They didn't improve the system. Like, the way it works right now is like not convenient for the artist, I don't think. It's more like,
it's a deterrent. It's a buzzkill. Lack of a better term.
It kind of is. Because like I said, the numbers don't check out the way they used to. And it's like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you sold the album, you got an album. But shit,
yeah,
to sell a million fucking albums is still impressive.
Yeah.
Come on.
It is. Nah, I ain't taking that. I ain't taking nothing away from that.
First week.
It was nuts.
First week, nigga. You got a million motherfuckers go to Best Buy the first week. Like, the fuck out.
Right.
That's nuts.
Right.
Yo.
Right. Nah, I can't take nothing away from that shit.
I know, I was getting every mixtape that dropped. Every single one.
Oh, yeah.
The G-Unit, I was on the same shit. Pooh Kid, Lloyd Banks, I was dropping. Anytime Lloyd Banks dropped something, I had to get it. J.R. Ryder, I had to get the shit. You know what I mean? Like, that type of shit was like, that's what I wanted to listen to on a bus. Like, bars, nigga. I need all this shit.
I was the same way. That's all I was fucking with for a while.
All bars. Yeah. Give me that State Prop 2. I need that. You said Christine Lloyd. It wasn't then Christine Young Neefy and shit. Young Gunners. I need that.
I used to listen to Cassidy and Papoose.
Oh, my
and,
God. What? What?
I listened to Pat Boos
go back up and forth of the alphabet 100 times.
Oh, that nigga used to just, yeah, he's ab.
Up and down that bitch all day. Like,
cool. Yeah.
Eminem.
Yeah, he was different.
That's when Eminem was going nuts.
Yeah.
Eminem was going nuts back then. Marshall Mathers LP, I would listen to that 1,500 times, no problem. No problem, yo.
Right. Right.
Yeah, that's what I mean by, like,
it's a different time.
Right. Look at this. J. Cole. Like, I wouldn't be, like, 250 is a normal number for J. Cole. 350 is a normal number for Kanye West. If Drake don't hit 4, he fell off. You see what I mean? Like,
right.
That's what I'm talking about. He's a different tax bracket. Like, nah, we know what you're going to do, y'all. We already know. Like, we want to hear dope music with it, though. That's where I'm at.
Well, you know, I don't know. We'll see. I don't know, like I said, I've been hearing back and forth, though. So I haven't heard Kanye's album. I'll listen to it eventually, but I'm in no rush right now. So.
It's dope. It will be,
I've been disappointed with Kanye's music for a while now.
I have.
It's been like very hit or miss for like years for me now. So it's
I'm the same way. Ever since Yeezus, even Life of Pablo, I barely listened to. I was just upset.
Life of Pablo was hit or miss for me. Ye was hit or miss. Like, Ye, I love the joint with him and Cudi.
Cudi,
the album they did.
I like. I love that album. I like Kids. What's it called?
Kids See Ghosts.
Kids See Ghosts. I fucked with that shit.
I fuck with Kids See Ghosts, but I didn't really like Ye like that.
Ye was cool. Yeah, he was cool. I like, because that's when he was going through his like bipolar, off his meds and shit like that.
Yeah.
So I love to see his thought process in that one. Like, I'm a Kanye West fan, so I look deeper in that. But Yeezus was no. You know what I mean? Like, Yeezus was no, the throne shit.
See, I feel like Yeezus got some joints, though. I'm going to be real with you.
No,
I feel like Yeezus is like 50% terrible and 50% like.
I say Yeezus got like 3 to 4. Yeezus got. If Yeezus was spades, I'd go bored with that shit.
Blood on the leaves. Blood on the leaves.
Blood on
black
leaves.
Skinhead.
Okay. What? Bound 2?
Bound 2 was hard. What's the fucking Guilt Trip? Guilt Trip, I missed the first time around. I had to come back for that. Like, oh, that song slaps. Fucking Hold My Liquor with Chief Keef is kind of hard. If it hits you in the right man. Sequence, then
yeah, but that's exactly what I was about to say. Like, if you listen to this new joint, if you listen, what the fuck is it? Donda. If you listen to this new joint, you probably got to be on a nice like road trip. Like, you got to go somewhere, and it takes about 30 minutes to get there. You get some dope tracks within there. Like, it's crazy. Especially if you got a nice little system in
it's
there.
It's 27 songs, too, right? I'm like,
yeah,
it's like an hour and 40 seconds. I'm like, just hearing that, I'm like,
No, it's like.
I'm exhausted just thinking about it. Like,
I was working on my bike when I listened to it, so I had time. You know what I mean? Like, I listened to that bitch like 3 times when I was working on my bike, so.
Okay.
But I had time then. It was just like, the first time through, it was like, that was cool. Second time through, it was like, oh, I ain't catch them bars. You know what I mean? Like, because I was focused on something else. It was like, oh, the locks is on that? I didn't even hear them. You know what I mean? Like, shit. Like, what? Jay-Z did that? You know what I mean? Then you thinking he ain't even spit no bars towards Drake. And then, like, on some songs, it's like, oh, this nigga's slick. And the features on there is crazy. Like, features is wild on there. Like, Fabio killed his shit. Everybody killed his shit. I ain't even gonna pick out artists. Everybody killed this shit on there. And musically, I'm telling you, like, if you're driving, had a dope system, and like, you know, got your equalizer right. You know what I mean? Like, that shit bumps.
Okay.
That shit hits so nice. Like, it's not even a lot of drums, but you get surrounded by just, he's a producer first. That's what I be trying to tell people. Especially when Soulja Boy and all them shit was like, I can't believe I'm not on the album. I can't believe he cut me from the, I'm like, y'all understand he a producer first.
I didn't really understand that either. I'm like, maybe they wanted a heads up. I guess they wanted a heads up that they weren't going to be on it, probably.
But the comment like that made you look like a little bitch, for real. It made it look like you had a whack verse to me. Coming out like that, it was like, oh, he cut your shit. Cut Chris Brown. No, but then Chris Brown leaked his shit. No,
Chris Brown leaked it. It sounded good.
It sounded good, but it didn't fit. Like, you got to understand.
I didn't hear the album, the snippet sounded good. So I didn't hear it in the context of the whole album. So
there's no cursing in the album. There is cursing, but everything's bleeped out, so you can tell what it is. It's very, it's not like your regular rap. It's a rap album with gospel music and a more gospel feel to the lyrics, where they're not talking about fucking bitches and, like, you know what I mean? Like, that, and that's what Chris Brown was on the whole time. Like, got this hoe over here and blah, 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 blah. And that's how Soulja Boy was. Kill this nigga, da, 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 da. Like, he was just like, we're not on. Pusha T's verse got cut. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But that's what it was. And when you hear their verses and then hear the album, it was like, oh yeah, no, they wouldn't. Nah. You know what I mean? Like, that wouldn't fit.
No car. I'm about to check it out. I gotta carve out time. Maybe on a trip to work or some shit.
That's what I'm saying.
I don't be having time. The music don't even fit into my schedule like that no more. Like,
I'm always sitting at the computer. Anytime I'm not doing something, I just press play on some shit. That's how I caught what's his name? TJ shit. He put it on a comment in Facebook and I was like, I'll listen to it. You know what I mean? I said, I'm about to press play. I'll let you know how I feel about it. That shit, okay. That shit was alright. He put work into it. I gave him a rating of 8.3. I felt like he was a little salty. I'm like, what the fuck you want me to? You know what I mean? you just wanted the 10, nigga.
Yeah, give him a real rating?
Yeah. He wanted one. No. I straight put this on.
That's not what you wanted. You wanted
No, fuck that. I tell you this. I put this all the time on my timeline. When people drop their music, I say, put that shit in my inbox or I'm going to just block you from my page. Like, people try to throw music on my page all the fucking time. So if you put it on my comments, I'm listening.
Oh, you put it in your comments.
Yeah. So I'm like, all right. Okay. Nah, you feeling gully?
Yeah.
Let's see how this shit. If that shit was trash, I would have trashed the fuck out of him on the comments. Like, don't ever post this shit on my shit ever again. Block, nigga. What the fuck is wrong with you?
Yeah.
Nah, but I went in and listened to a couple and I was like, all right, I got to start this from the beginning. That shit.
I think I want to say I heard something from a few months ago. I saw an ad, matter of fact, on IG.
And that was probably that shit.
Freestyle or something. It wasn't bad. So I got to check this right out.
The only thing I said to him, I was like, I think you just need the production value up. The beats sound good and everything, but you could tell the mixing wasn't done professionally. You could tell the beats weren't mixed professionally. The cohesiveness of the album wasn't done professionally. And I'm saying professionally because it's like, I straight told him, I'm like, you're no longer, by the sound of this, you're no longer local. This isn't, you know what I mean? Like, you gotta try to stop being better than the local dudes. You're at the bottom of the industry now. You know what I mean? Like, you're fighting with these dudes now. I don't see you, I don't even compare you to the local, I'm comparing you to people who rap like this in the industry at that level.
Right. Right.
I'm like, shit was right. Shit was well put together. And I'm like, listen to that robbery shit. Listen to that shit.
I'm gonna check that shit out.
I wasn't even mad at it.